Hello and welcome to Planet Side 2 video guide series. My name is Iridar and today I'm gonna give you a few examples on how to use my weapon analysis toolbox. First, let's download and open it. Acknowledge the security warning and allow use of macros. Let's say we want to take a look on how Gauss saw performs against nanoweave in close quarters. Find the Gauss saw in the list and double click on it. This will import its stats into other pages. Switch to damage page. We can see that the inside saw's maximum damage range, its time to kill against a full nanoweave target is increased by 50%. Quite a lot for 20% damage reduction. Now let's see what high velocity ammo does for the saw. Return to the stats page and right click the saw to import its stats into second position on the damage page. Let's add HVA to the second saw. Notice how minimum damage range increases and maximum damage range decreases. We can run the bullets to kill threshold simulation and see that saw with HVA has BTK thresholds are reduced by 2 meters. However, at 85 meters it does slightly higher damage. This doesn't change time to kill against a standard target though. Now let's check where HVA can have a bigger effect. Return to stats page and double click and then right click the pulse RC to import its stats into both positions on the damage page. Add HVA to the second pulse RC and run calculations. As we can see, HVA here increases the length of the 7-shot kill threshold by 10 meters, at the cost of reducing the 6-shot threshold by 2 meters. Press delete to remove the graph. Now let's go to recoil page and take a look at Pulse RC performance. Stats were already imported when we clicked on it on the stats page last time. Click calculate stability. As we can see, Pulse RC has very small average horizontal deviation. Let's reduce the graph scale to have a better look. So, statistically, Pulse RC spends about 50% of the time dead on target, and the other half 0.117 degrees away from the target. That's a very small deviation, as expected from the Pulse RC, the truly unique weapon when it comes to horizontal recoil stability. For comparison, let's take a look at Cyclone's recoil. Since it has much more recoil, we're gonna have to reduce the graph scale. Here we can see a much less smooth picture, since Cyclone Crosshair has a chance to land pretty much anywhere. Now let's take a look at how Cyclone's recoil compares to Armistice. Let's write down Cyclone's average deviation and copy-paste its probability distribution graph. Paste as a picture to make sure it remains unchanged. Now import Armistice stats. Once again, click Calculate. We can see that Armistice has a larger average deviation, and we can also overlay the graphs on top of each other, so we can see why. Armistice has a greater chance to be kicked further from the start. Now let's see how Armistice and Cyclone compare in damage properties. On the damage page, Armistice is already in the first position, so return to the stats page and right-click on the Cyclone to import it in the second position. Let's add softpoint ammo to both and run calculations. About as you would expect. We can compare their time to kill at 15 meters. Double click the headshot ward to make calculations for headshots. We can notice the Cyclone's infamous super short 3 headshot time to kill. Double click the resist shield value to make calculations as if we're shooting a resist shield heavy. Notice that we'll have to click headshots again to make calculations for the head. We can see that Cyclone still has a time to kill advantage with all headshots within maximum damage range. Now let's take a look at Cyclone's cone of fire performance. Most of its stats are already imported, but I'll have to manually input its cone of fire stats. First, let's take a look at body shots. We can see that Cyclone can effectively one burst a standard target within 30 meters. Based only on cone of fire performance, Cyclone can land 10 shots at target center mass at that range, and each shot will deal about 126 damage. 10 shots will deal enough damage to kill a full nanowave target, but to account for recoil and possible aiming mistakes, I'd reduce that range to 20-25 meters. Now let's take a look at headshots. By yellow highlights, we can see that Cyclone isn't guaranteed to land even one headshot at 40 meters or further, but it can effectively one burst an enemy in the head within 20 meters or so. I don't want to make any balancing point with this video, it's merely to demonstrate my toolbox functionality. Don't hesitate to ask any questions on how to use it, and feel free to suggest new features. The guide is now concluded, my name is Iridar, and I'll see you next time.